At this time, and we have a quorum. First of all, confirmation of the minutes of this 18th meeting held on the 18th of March 2016. Minutes have been forwarded to members. If there are no proposals for amendments, can we confirm the minutes, please? Matters arising. My meeting with the Chief Secretary for Administration, nothing to report. Business for the Council meeting on the 13th and 14th of April 2016. On the 13th and 14th of April, the arrangements has been forwarded to members. The President has accepted the administration's proposal that the Copyright Amendment Bill 2014 will go after the Appropriation Bill 2016. This will allow members to speak on the Appropriation Bill second reading first, and then afterwards, in accordance with Rule 44 of the Rules of Procedure, we could deal with the motion on the Copyright Amendment Bill. On the 13th of April, the meeting will start at 11 and end at around 8 p.m. And then on the 14th of April, Thursday, the meeting will resume at 9 a.m. until we complete the business on the agenda. Thank you. Any questions? No? Tabling of papers. Report number 16/15 to 16 of the House Committee on Consideration of Subsidy Legislation and Other Instruments. This report covers subsidy legislation, which is the Pharmacy and Poisons Amendment Regulation 2016, to the amendment of which will expire at the Council meeting of the 13th of April. No members asked to speak. Questions, 22 written questions have been arranged. Bill resumption of debate on second reading. Appropriation Bill 2016. In accordance with Rule 36(5) of the Rules of Procedure, each member will have 15 minutes to speak. Mrs. Kang, for the Council meeting on the the 20th of April, 22 written questions have been slotted. Bills first and second reading, no notice has been received yet. Bills resumption of debate on second reading, committee stage and third reading. First, Appropriation Bill 2016, response by the administration. And then there are other bills scheduled. Judiciary 5-day week miscellaneous amendments Bill 2016. Inland Revenue Amendment Number 2 Bill 2016. The Hong Kong Institute of Education Amendment Bill 2016 and Chinese Permanent Cemeteries Amendments Bill 2015. Questions, please? Reports of Bills Committees and Subcommittees. Report of the Bills Committee on Promotion of Recycling and Proper Disposal Product Container Amendment Bill 2015. Dr. Loh Wai Kwok. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. The Promotion of Recycling and Proper Disposal Product Container Amendment Bill 2015 seeks to provide for a statutory regulatory framework to implement the Mandatory Producer Responsibility Scheme, PRS, for product containers. The Bills Committee notes that the proposed mandatory PRS will first cover glass beverage containers. The administration will impose a recycling levy on registered suppliers and appoint glass management contractors to collect and handle waste glass containers. In the course of scrutiny, the Bills Committee considered mainly the definition of beverage, charging and exemption mechanism of recycling levy, treatment of waste glass containers, and cost benefits of the proposed scheme. Details of the deliberations are in the written report. The administration will be moving committee stage amendments. The Bills Committee has no objection to those CSAs. The Bills Committee will not be moving any CSAs. The Bills Committee is not in objection to the resumption of the second reading debate of the bill on the 20th of April. Thank you. Next, a report of the Bills Committee on Companies and Winding Up and the Miscellaneous Provisions Amendment Bill 2015, Mr. Wong Teng Kwong. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. The bill seeks to amend the Companies Winding Up The Bills Committee seeks to amend the Companies Winding Up and Miscellaneous Provisions Amendment Ordinance the related subsidy legislation to increase protection of creditors, streamline the winding up process, and further enhance the integrity of the process. The Bills Committee supports the main proposals of the bill. The Bills Committee considered the following issues: power to court to set aside transactions at an undervalue, increasing protection for director-initiated creditors, voluntary winding up, enhancing the requirements for the calling of the first creditors meeting for creditors, voluntary winding up, streamlining the winding up process, example, prescribing the maximum and minimum number of members of a committee of inspection, COI, allowing remote attendance for COI meetings through the use of technology, and approval of costs and charges of liquidators agents by COI. Other issues considered include strengthening the regulation of provisional liquidators and liquidators and enhancing the public examination procedure in the winding up regime. Furthermore, members discussed issues related to the bill, including shortening the time gap between the winding up process and provision of ex gratia payments to employees from the protection of wages on insolvency fund, and increasing the maximum amounts on preferential payments under Section 265 of the ordinance. The Bills Committee does not object to the committee stage amendments to be moved by the administration. The Bills Committee will not be moving any CSA. The Bills Committee is not against the resumption of the second reading debate of the bill at the council meeting on the 20th of April. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Next, report of the Bills Committee on Eastern Harbour Crossing Legislation Amendment Bill 2015, Mr. Chen Kam Lam. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. The 30-year build, operate and transfer franchise for the Eastern Harbour Crossing is due to expire on the 7th of August 2016. The bill seeks to provide a legal basis for the operation and management of EHC as a government tunnel. The Bills Committee held a total of 3 meetings to consider the bill. The Bills Committee supports the bill. Members considered mainly the toll levels of EHC, traffic volume of the three cross-harbour tunnels, toll strategy, and so on. The deliberations of the Bills Committee are in the report. The Bills Committee does not oppose the resumption of the second reading of the bill at the council meeting on the 20th of April 2016. The Bills Committee will not be moving any committee stage amendments. Members note that Mr. Wu Chi-wai, Mr. Raymond Wong, and Mr. Tan Kang-pyu may consider moving amendments in relation to the EHC tolls. But if I may add, Mr. Chairman, whether these CSAs could be moved would depend on the ruling of the President. Thank you. Next, report of the Bills Committee on Inland Revenue Amendment Number 4, Bill 2015. As Mr. Kenneth Leung is not here yet, perhaps I will report on his behalf.
Held 3 meetings with the administrations to examine the Inland Revenue Amendment Number 4, Bill 2015. The bill seeks to amend the Inland Revenue Ordinance to give profits tax concession to qualifying corporate treasury centers, make provision for profit tax purposes regarding interest on money borrowed from or lent to associated corporations, treat regulatory capital securities as debt securities. The bill also seeks to amend the stamp duty ordinance to give stamp duty relief in relation to regulatory capital securities. Details of the deliberations of the Bills Committee are set out in the report issued to members. In the course of the scrutiny of the bill, members have sought clarifications on the interpretation and application of the various technical amendments proposed in the bill. The administration has responded to members' queries and would propose committee stage amendments to address members' concerns and to refine the drafting of the bill. The Bills Committee supports the resumption of the second reading debate on the bill at the Council meeting of 20th April 2016. The Bills Committee has not proposed any committee stage amendments in its name.
2015年。Next, a report of the Bills Committee on Electoral Legislation and Miscellaneous Amendments, number Bill 2, Bill 2015. Mr. Yip Kok Him, please. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. The Electoral Legislation Miscellaneous Amendments, number 2, Bill 2015, seeks to introduce technical amendments to various pieces of electoral legislation to align certain deadlines for filing election returns, updates the electorate of the election committee subsectors and the corresponding legislative council functional constituencies, and align the electoral arrangements of the EC subsector elections and the chief executive election with the other public elections. The Bills Committee held a total of 4 meetings with the administration. We also received views from deputations and the public. The deliberations of the Bills Committee are in the report. The Bills Committee notes that Mr. Sin Chong Kai, Mr. Charles Mok, and Mr. Kenneth Leung have indicated that they will be moving committee stage amendments on the bill to expand the electorate of 4 functional constituencies. The administration does not agree to such amendments. The Bills Committee and the administration will not be moving any committee stage amendments. The Bills Committee does not oppose to the resumption of the second reading debate of the bill at the council meeting on the 20th of April. Thank you. If I may remind members, if you wish to move any amendments to the 5 bills above, the deadline is the 11th of April, Monday. Report of the subcommittee on 6 pieces of subsidiary legislation relating to over-the-counter derivative transactions gazetted on the 5th of February 2016. I will report as the chairman of the subcommittee. The regulatory framework for the over-the-counter derivatives market was provided for in the Securities and Futures Amendment Ordinance 2014. The framework is to be implemented in stages by way of subsidiary legislation. The 6 items of subsidiary legislation seek to implement stage 2 of the regulatory regime, covering mandatory clearing, expanded mandatory reporting, related record-keeping obligations, and prescription of relevant fees. The subcommittee held 1 meeting with the administration and the Securities and Futures Commission to consider the 6 items. Members considered if the exit arrangements from clearing obligations under the clearing rules may be abused, rationale for deferring expanded reporting obligations, ways to set fees for reporting to the trade repository and for destination as central counterparties, and implementation timetable for the remaining stages of the OTC regulatory regime. The subcommittee has no objection to the 6 items of subsidiary legislation. The detailed deliberations of the subcommittee are in the report.
To the position on bills on bills committees and subcommittees as of the 7th of April, 15 BCs in progress, and then 11 subcommittees under the House Committee, and then there are 2 on the waiting list. Report of the delegation of the panel on education on its duty visit to Germany and Switzerland to study the vocational education and training systems in these 2 countries, and the priority allocation of a debate slot to the leader of the delegation, Mr. Yu Qingjun.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. The delegation of the panel on education conducted a study visit to Germany and Switzerland in September 2015 to study the vocational education and training VET system of the 2 countries. I'm now submitting the report on behalf of the panel. The experience of Germany and Switzerland in implementing VET can provide useful reference for Hong Kong in the implementation and promotion of vocational and professional education and training. So the panel agrees that in accordance with Rule 14AH of the House Rules, we will seek the permission of the House Committee for a priority debate slot so that I can move a motion debate as the leader of the delegation and the deputy of the panel at the Council meeting on the 1st of June. This will allow members to express their views on the subject and for the administration to give a response. The wordings of the motion are in Annex 2 to the paper. The panel also proposes that apart from having this debate, there should be just one more members' motion debate without legislative effect on that particular council meeting. Well, I ask the House Committee to grant this request. Members, do you agree to give a priority allocation slot to the this debate? So, and it will be one plus one. Oh, if there are no other questions, the meeting is adjourned. Thank you.